This is a crime, the city, and a wailing stagnation among the people. For behold, the darkness covers the earth, and gross darkness the people. But this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are all of them snared in holes, and they are laid in prison houses. They are for a prey, and none safe restore. Suddenly, comes a light in form of a word as a man to God's servant, saying,
clap offering. Somebody give the Lord a clap offering. Somebody give the Lord a clap offering wherever you are. Give them praise, give them praise. Let's give them praise, let's worship Him. Let's worship Him, let's worship Him. Let's adore Him. Come and give them praise with your tongue.
Shanta la brade de los dobrales.
Quelque chose de possible dans la vallée à l'os. Never seen God, say that I am no more God. Man can say I am no more man. I've never seen God forsaking his own people. The reason why you are standing before him this last Sunday of the month is because God is your God. God is your provider. God is your protector. God is all that you need. And I give him praise for the last Sunday of the month. I worship you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, we have worshiped. In Jesus' name, we have worshiped. Come on, somebody, welcome your neighbor to church this morning. And say, welcome to church, welcome to church, welcome to church. Tell the person, today is your miracle day. Today is your miracle day. Today is your miracle day. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Please be comfortably seated as I welcome you to a glorious Thanksgiving service this morning, the service of signs and wonders. I welcome you to your miracle day. I welcome you to your miracle Sunday. Today is your miracle day. If you believe, say, today is my miracle day. Say it convincingly. Today is my miracle day. Why? Because today is the last Sunday of the month. And it's the month of signs and wonders. It's a month of answered prayers. It's a month of what? Answered prayers. So, and in this last Sunday of the month, whatever God has not answered you since the beginning of the year, since the beginning of this month, God must answer you this morning. I said, God must answer you this morning. If you believe it, you say it with all your heart and say, amen. I said, God must answer me this morning. God must answer you this morning. Say it with all your heart. I said, God must answer me this morning. It's a miracle service. Are you expecting any miracle? Are you expecting any miracle? Let me see people that expect a miracle this morning. It's a miracle working God. It's a miracle working God. He's been on fire in the America. It's a miracle working God. It's a miracle working God. Today, in this service, after service, somebody is going home with an unusual miracle. Somebody is going with an unusual miracle in the name of Jesus. Quickly, let's go down to the business of the day. Why am I in church? Why are you in church? And why are you here and not there? Why are you in Wami this morning and not seated at home? Why are you not seated at home but you are in Wami and not in any other places? because you are here for the God of Wami to visit you. I am here for God of Wami. I didn't come here for any pastors. I came here for God. And I know that God will meet me this morning with all my heart desire. If you believe it, say it to yourself, this morning, God will meet me with my heart desires, with signs and wonders, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God is about to do something. Your miracle will surprise the world. I said your miracle will surprise the world. I said your miracle will surprise the world. I said your miracle will surprise the world. Your miracle will surprise you yourself. In the name of Jesus. We have started the topic since the beginning of the month. This month is our month of answers prayers. And we've been looking at the mysteries of answers prayer via signs and wonders. The mysteries of signs and wonder that is called miracle, or miracle that are called signs and wonders. Hallelujah. I don't know where people thought that it has ended with you. Step 41 to heaven. Wherever Satan and his agent have concluded on your matter that it is finished. Wherever Satan and his agent and the enemy have said you cannot make it, this is why God will do a miracle in your life. Because every hand that I lifted up, your face has been lifted up this morning. Your lives have been lifted up this morning. Your faith have been lifted up this morning. Your miracles have been lifted up this morning. In the name of... In the beginning of the month, God saw us in the part one of this revelation, who are the candidates for miracle? Who are the candidates for miracle? I'm still trying to remind you and to recap. Why am I in church? Why are you here? And not in the next church? And not in your house sleeping? Because God has started a team this month. Who are the candidates for miracle? For signs and wonder? I am one. You are one of them. That's why you are here. People that are desperately in need of God. I'm trying to recap the part one of the surface of signs and wonders. Are you qualified for signs and wonders? Are you qualified for signs and wonders? Then what are your cases? Are you hopeless? Are you in any hopeless situation? Are you in any helpless situation? People that are desperate for God are people that are candidates for signs and wonders. Can I tell you, true people of the Lord, I'm desperate for the Lord. I'm what? I am desperate. I am hunger for the miracle of God. And that miracle is today, in the name of Jesus. How many of you remember that, the part one? How many of you remember the part two of this signs and wonders service? My miracle, my family restoration. Do you remember? How many of you remember the part three? The scarcity miracle, my birthright. Miracle is my birthright. But why is the miracle and signs and wonder are scarce? Can some of you remind me what we taught last week, Sunday? This is going to be a dialogue season. Somebody want to remind me? Yes. Who are the candidate, or what? What did you learn last Sunday?
Miracles for believers and non-believers.
How did they?
miracle is for believers and non-believers.
Miracles are for believers and non-believers. Come and give the Lord a clap of it for her. That's a student. Another person to give me. What are the facts about miracles? Facts about miracles.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, sir.
So we talked about nature and characteristics of signs and wonders.
Yes.
Miracle. We said that it is available for everybody. It is available everywhere and anywhere. Miracle is not for those who look for it. Miracle is for those who wait for it. That those who look for miracle, they sink in mirage.
Yes. Those who look, I don't want to forget that word of wisdom. Those who look for miracle, they what? They sink in mirage. Miracle is in that place. Let's go there. Miracle is in that prophet. Let's go there. Miracle is in that church. Let's go there. You are a miracle seeker. You are not God seeker. And they sink. The what? They sink. Because as long as you are a miracle seeker, you will keep going from one place to another. Even when you get one miracle, it would be enough. You will still be looking for another one. You will still be looking for another one. Until what? Until you sink. Pursuing a mirage. A mirage. That's why we said, where are the miracles located? Somebody tell me, miracles are located where? Everywhere. Miracles are located, where are the places? In church, in mosque, in club, at bus stop, miracle is there. Miracle is in the sea, on the air, in the forest. In fact, miracle is in Sangoma House. If miracle is not in Sangoma House, why are people going to Sangoma's to look for miracle? But you see, people that look for miracle, they sink in the mirage. Because one place will never be enough for miracle seeker until they get themselves to Nyanga and Sangoma House. And there they will sink. Watch it. I'm afraid of miracle seekers. Wami can never be enough for them. Jesus is coming can never be enough for them. There is no church that can be enough for miracle seekers. They jump from one Sunday to another Sunday. They jump from one crusade to another crusade. And they will jump until they jump until they jump onto their what? Onto mirage. What are the natures of miracles? What are the advantages of miracles? What are the disadvantages of miracles? This morning, I want to take you a little bit further on the scarcity miracle. Last week we talked about the scarcity miracle. God revealed to us that this scarcity miracle actually is your birthright. Is what? Is my birthright. If miracle wonders are my birthright, then why is it scarce? So God wants to surprise me and you this morning in the same order. He revealed unto us the scarcity miracle. In the midst of the scarcity miracle, there are surplus miracle. In the what? In the midst of the scarcity miracle, there are surplus miracle. So I'm showing you the revelation. What the Lord has been revealing to me about the churches today, about the people of, about the children of God today, everyone under the sound of my voice on the internet, on YouTube, you will find this topic related to what you are looking for. God began to show me, son, why do you think that this church is too big? Why do you think this church is too small? Why do you think this church that started 2 weeks ago is like this? Why do you think this church that started 20 years ago are like this? God said to me, my sons, all sons and daughters in the Lord, they are all miracle seekers. And they are all sick. And they are stinking. I said, God, show me more. So, between the first week of this month and up to now, God is speaking to me regularly concerning how to overtake his people, how to redeem his people from sinking into their mirage, into their birthright, which is their miracle, because they are for signs and wonder. God created men and women in his own image, and he said he created us for signs and wonder. But signs and wonder is not happening in my life, they are not happening in your life, because the enemy has told me the mystery, the importance, the ingredient of signs and wonder from your hand, and has making you a what? A wanderer. God started speaking to me. He said, where are all these people to go, multitude going? He said, they are wanderers. Wonders and looking for miracle. Go to any churches now. Go to churches where you have, you find 1,000, 10,000, 50,000. Only 1% are there to hear the word of God. 99% are there to say, yes, do it, pastor. Do it, prophet. Say it. Go deeper. All of those stuff, they are looking for miracle. Yes, pastor, call my phone number. Yes, you want phone number. Pastors are now, most of the pastors today, they are no longer pastors. They are also miracle dashers. They just dash you miracle. They dash you. They dash you. And you know when somebody dash you, he can collect it back. He say, okay, I'm not giving you anymore. So a lot of people are dying looking for miracle, whereas they themselves, they are miracle. As I want you to examine yourself. I know for you being here today, you are not a miracle seeker. You are a God seeker. Yes or no? Come and give the Lord a clap for yourself. Give the Lord a clap for yourself. So you have passed. You have passed. So, and I want you to remain on that level. So, in the scarcity miracle, then somebody will ask me, pastor, then where is my own miracle? There is a surplus miracle. That's what? There are more than 1,001 miracle in your life if you can assess them. If what? If you can assess them. How can I assess a surplus miracle? Miracle, again, the fact, let's go back quickly again to the fact about miracle. Miracle, signs and wonder are for the wanderers. People that are wandering around, miracle is for them. People that are wanderers in their mind, in their souls, in their spirit, they are wondering why, or where, or how, or when is my miracle? People that are what? That are situated, waiting for miracle. Miracle meet them. No people that are looking or seeking for miracle. Miracles are for wanderers. That is, if you are imagining in your heart, in your mind, oh God, when is my miracle? A lot of people out there are seeking for miracle. Where is my miracle? But they never ask, when is my miracle? Where is my miracle? Miracle seekers. God seeker, when is my miracle? Miracle seekers says, where? So every time they ask that question, Satan will tell them, there. Every time you ask that question, where is my miracle? Satan will say, there. Today you say, where is my miracle? Why? Satan will say, dear. Why? Satan will say, how can you have miracle? Because you are a sinner. Are you getting what I'm saying? Miracle seeker, they say, where is my miracle? Satan will say, oh, okay, next Sunday, your miracle is in Wami. Where? Next, another Sunday, they say, where is my miracle? Satan will tell them, your miracle is in Tami. Another Sunday, they will say, where is your miracle? Your miracle is in Pretoria. Another time, they will say, where is my miracle? Your miracle is in Canada, it's in Nigeria, it's in Zimbabwe. They run from north to pole, asking where. Instead of asking themselves, when is my miracle? I want somebody sitting here and hearing me now say, Lord, when is my miracle? Say it. When is my miracle? Until you know the channels of miracle, you are not a candidate. Until you position yourself to the channel, until you position yourself appropriately to the channels of miracle, you can never and you may never be a candidate for miracle. Signs and wonders. I want to quickly show you what are the channels of miracle. So before you ask the question, where is my miracle? When is my miracle? I'd like you to assess yourself. Are you in line? Are you properly positioned to your miracle? What are the channels of miracle? Excuse me, people of God. It is wrong for you to put a bank, to put your account in Absa, and then you are going to Standard Bank. Say, give me my money. Are they going to give you? Hello? Are they going to give you? You saw everybody, the queue. You are just going to Bafontein, or you are going to Soweto, or you are going to Alexander, and you saw everybody, the queue at ATM, Standard Bank ATM. And every one of them, they are coming out, they are counting money. And then you started and you are looking at them. Where are these people getting this money? And then you went there and you queue. Whereas you have a Standard Bank card, but you went and queue at FNB. Or you saw people in FNB Bank. And then you also now went there and stand and say, you stand like a Standard Bank. This is my bank. And when it is your turn, everybody was going, then you went there, you put your card. What is going to happen? What is the ATM going to say? Say, you are not a candidate. In what? Wrong address, wrong location, wrong mind. He say, you are stupid. Get out here, take your card. Hello? It's like that. They are giving money there. Let me go there. When it gets to your tongue, before you even get to your tongue, Satan will say, no, it's not here. It's there. Some people, because they are miracle seeker, God have said, today I'm going to surprise this man. And he kept your miracle to the last of the service. 5 minutes to the end of the service, somebody say, this church is not powerful. This church, they are too small. Miracle is not happening here. Let me go to where there are large congregation. Large congregation, 1,000 even. Before the miracle reached them, they are dead. Hello? What are the channels of miracle? Number one, channels of miracle, the word of God. The undiluted word of God. Anywhere you find yourself where the truth words of God are being preached, where the man of God is preaching the true words of God with undiluted compromise, wait there. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 9, verse 27. No, the word of God, he said, and he sent forth his word, and the word healed them all. What? He sent forth his word, and his word healed them all. The first standard of miracle is, are you seated under the word of God? Not under the philosophy of men, not under the historical pastors, not under pastor, write down preach on. Are you seated under a businessman pastor? 90% of the message, bring. It's a beginning to you, and that is what you like. One seat, 1,000. If you want to have a 1 million this week, one seat. Come and donate 1 million here now. Come and donate 1,000 here now for VIP seat. That's what some of the many of us you like. That's what some of us they like. If I come with a gymnastic now and say, "Hey, people of the Lord, I just returned now from Bishop David Oyedepo. I just returned now from Shaddai shall not die. I just returned now from Israel. God gave me this mantle that all of you, any first five people that are seated on this red floor now, with 1,000 rand, you God will give it 1 million rand this week. Some of you will jump here now. You want gymnastic, not the word. Not the word. Because God said, he sent forth his word. The tenacity of every miracle is based on the word of God. Say word of God. Tell the neighbor, go for the words of God. Wherever you see men of God preaching, your spirit will align with it. Let me tell you the truth. Wherever the word of God is being preached with undiluted excuses, your spirit will align with it. Why? Because there are some bitter truth you will hear from that word of God that will be turning your heart and your mind, leave this place. It's because the word of God is being preached. Not to suit you. Most of the time you want man of God to preach the word that will suit you. And so many pastors now, because they know that you're a miracle seeker, so they'll preach what will suit you so that you can be suited in that place and be rotten. Word of God. Go and sit wherever there is word of God. And your spirit man will tell you that this man is preaching the word of God. He sent forth his word, and his word he led us. Channels of miracle. The only thing that can deliver me and you from every situation or every crisis, if you truly need miracle, if you truly need the signs and wonder that no man has ever recorded, position yourself wherever the word of God is being preached. Position yourself. Number two, are you a candidate for signs and wonders? Are you a candidate for miracle? Are you in the proper channel? Did you position yourself? Position yourself in faith. Hearing the word of God, doing the word of God with faith. Hearing the word of God, being patient in God with faith. Faith is what determines your miracle level. Your faith level determines your miracle level. I remember I said it last Sunday also. Those that have faith in him, there are two types of faith, I said. Those that have faith in him to do, and those that have faith in themselves to receive. I said, somebody here will receive his wedding invitation this week. Shout and receive. Somebody will look at left and right. Who is going to marry me here? Who is going to marry me here? And then they will keep quiet. Faith! They have faith to come to church, but they didn't have faith to receive. Look at this. Matthew chapter 9, verse 27. And when Jesus departed hence, two blind men followed him, crying and saying, Thou son of David, have mercy on us. Matthew chapter 9, verse 27. Verse 28. And when he was coming to the house, the blind man came to him, and Jesus said unto them, Believe ye that I am able to do this? They said unto him, Yea, Lord. Verse 29. Then touched he their eyes, saying, According to your faith, be it unto you. And Jesus, and the just shall live by faith. According to your faith, Jesus spoke. They received the word with their faith. You can't use my faith for your miracle. You also need to release your faith. And the miracle you are looking for will be in your hand. The just shall live by faith. Faith in the word of God will deliver expressly your miracle. Faith in the spoken word, faith in the written word. So, talking about faith in the written, in the spoken, everything that I'm telling you today now, if you release your faith to it, you will soon discover that the same testimony we heard of people in the Bible will be heard about you in the name of Jesus. Number three channels of miracle, prayers. Are you a man and a woman of prayers? Or you are coming to church that I might pray for you? So you see, most times when after service, people go to the man of God, a man of God invited guest, say, after man of God has preached and do man of things, you see people still going to the man of God after the service. Pastor, pray for me. It bothers my heart. When I begin to command prayer now, when I begin to command a mass prayer, why can't you pray with yourself? Why do you think only when you come to my office, or when you go to Pastor Dayo's office, or when you call Professor So's office, that's only when your prayer can be heard? Most of the time, it leads us into what? Disappointment, frustration. Because you are believing, or you are relying on my own prayer for your own answer. Please, I want you to engage yourself in the school of prayers. It will solve so many problems. It will deliver to you expressly. Can I ask you a question? If somebody is in coma, do you call Pastor Tao, please pray for me, when you are already in coma? You get what I'm saying? Somebody in coma could not even talk, could not use his phone, could not reach his phone, and then you now begin to do imaginary phone call. Pastor Tao, Pastor Dayo, please pray for me. Hello? Uncle, is it possible? This is the time you can release yourself into what? Dangerous prayers. So I want to quickly show you what are the type of prayers that bring forth miracles that you have been long desiring for. Number one type of prayer, intercessory prayer. What? Intercessory prayers. Philippians chapter 1 verse 19 says, For I know that these are turned to my salvation through your prayer. Intercessory prayers bring forth miracle. What is intercessory prayer? When you begin to intercede, you begin to intercede for somebody. Job received his own miracle when he began to intercede pray for his own friends. I like you at your own pleasure time, at your own prayer time. For once, don't pray for yourself. Begin to pray for the church. Begin to pray for your brother and sister. Begin to pray for your friends. For once. And as you begin to pray for others, God begin to do your own intercessory prayers. Number two type of prayer. I want to quickly deliver this message that we can pray. Warfare prayer. Say warfare prayer. Say warfare prayer. Matthew chapter 11 verse 12. The Bible says, and for the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and violence taken it by force. That is what is called warfare prayer. Every man or woman that desire miracle, I know when you are looking for miracle and when you are expecting magic. Grow yourself with whatever miracle you are looking for. The kingdom of God survive violent taken it by force. It's called warfare prayer. Engage the warfare prayer until when every desperate situation require desperate action. Every desperate situation require desperate answer. In the name of Jesus, I uproot every seed of sorrow in my life. Prayer with what? With violent. Doctor said this cancer is going to kill you or kill the person, and you are praying, oh God, remove this cancer. You are enjoying it. Cancer is like a bingo that is barking at you to destroy you. How many of you see play with bingo? Bingo is biting your first feet, and you say, bingo, don't bite me, oh. Bingo, you see, you are biting me, oh. It will bite more. Until you turn also to bingo. Bingo, get out! That's what is called warfare prayer. Warfare prayer, you pray in the Holy Ghost, you pray in understanding. With what? With energy. With all your power. When you see a woman in labor, what is that woman doing? Is travailing, is pushing violently, and then a miracle baby come forth. But when you see a woman travailing or in labor, they say push. He said, doctor, can't you help me to push? Doctor, help me to push now. And that's what most of us are doing. Pastor, help me to pray now. I will pray. Nurses will do their own. But the ultimate miracle you are looking for is in your hand. And God has placed this ministry in that position. Warfare prayer. Pray! Warfare prayer. I reject poverty. I reject sorrow in the name of Jesus. But time, that is the time somebody will be saying, I reject poverty. I reject sorrow. And then you are using your phone. And then you are reading your SMS. Time for warfare prayer. That is the time you are reading your phone. In the name of Jesus, I reject poverty. In the name of Jesus, I reject poverty. I reject sorrow. I reject weeping. He's reading SMS. So, in fact, he will not even know when you say, I accept weeping. I accept sorrow. Because your mind is not there. And Satan will say, oh, okay, he wants sorrow. Please give him more, give him more, give him more. Because you are not a man or woman of violent prayer. When the violent prayer is praying, Satan look at them and say, excuse me, there is a fire going there. Don't go near that person. But when Satan see the way you are praying, hallelujah, hallelujah, let us pray in the name of Jesus. I reject poverty, I reject sorrow. And then Satan will say, that one is lying. There is no fire around her. Please give him more sorrow. Engage in what? In what? Violent prayer. I think I want to read my phone also. Another type of prayer is corporate or prayer of agreement. Prayer of agreement. We saw that when church was praying for Paul, there was a miracle. Corporate agreement. prayer of agreement. Prayer of agreement is corporate prayer. That's why we are coming to church. So many people will say, I'm a prayer warrior, but they are sitting in their house. As I'm talking to you now, so many people are sitting in their house. They said they are prayer warrior. They said they are looking for signs and miracle and wonder. They said they are looking for miracle. They said they are prayer warrior. They said they are evangelists. They said they are prophet. They are prophetess. But they are in their house now. They are on their bed. Satan will slap you when you are praying, when you are alone. You need power. You need people to gather momentum with you. You need what? You need people to gather momentum with you. As I'm speaking to you now, a lot of people are sitting in their house, sleeping. They said they are prayer warrior. They will pray for 5 minutes with TV. They are gone. Wednesday service. That's why we instituted Wednesday service, so that people can come, we can gather ourselves together corporately and pray together, so that the energy of one will support the others. But no, people will not come. They are prayer warrior. They can do everything in their house. They can do everything on their bed. Satan will slap you. And that's why a lot of people's miracles are delayed. A lot of people's miracles are stony. Because Satan made them to feel that they know they are very strong. You are very strong in prayer. Come to church for corporate prayer. Corporate prayer. Another type of prayer is personal supplication prayer. Personal supplication prayer. When you are in a desperate situation, you begin to ask the Lord, God, why is my case like this? Why is my case like this? Oh Lord, answer me! Oh Lord, answer me! Anna and Jabez, a supplication prayer. Oh God, answer me. God, answer me. A desperate man like Hannah, a desperate woman like Hannah, a desperate man like Jabez will pray to the Lord with all their supplication. Are you in that prayer attitude? I see a man and a woman that begin to enter into personal supplication. Message is going on like this. Your mind is fully released. Your mouth is, Lord, this money. Lord, this money. Makuta parito satalaba. Every time a word is released on the altar, you take it. Personal supplication. God, that is me. Lapuka tarabalaba. Hey, I will not sink. I will not sink. Personal supplication. In church, you will see some people, they are talking and gossiping from the beginning of the service to the end. In church, you will see some people, they are glued to their cell phone under the pretext that they are reading Bible. No, they are reading messages. In church, a lot of people's mind are on their problem. A lot of our minds are on our situation. When we are supposed to release our spirit to supplication, then why did you come to church? You came the same way, you went back the same way. It's a self-punishment. You and the person that is seated at home, you are no better than each other. And you went back and you say, hey, there is no power in that church, there is no miracle. What is your own heart? God seek for your heart. He didn't find anything. He only find how you are, that woman you are taking of yesterday in your mind. He only find the bitterness in your heart of yesterday. He couldn't find your supplication. Come wherever you are now. I'd like you to just pray. Say, oh Lord, search my heart. Say it wherever you are. Oh Lord, search my heart this morning. Oh Lord, search my heart this morning. Another type of prayer is kingdom prayer. kingdom prayer, which is soul winning prayer. Seek ye for the kingdom of God and everything shall be added unto you. Seek ye for the kingdom of God and everything shall be added unto you. That is called kingdom prayer. Lord, release your angel to gather the multitude. Oh Lord, I pray for my ministry. Oh Lord, I pray for your work. I pray. But how can you pray for God's work when you yourself, you are not a worker in the house of the Lord? But somebody is expecting a miracle. The only prayer this person knows how to pray is, Lord, give me money. Lord, give me wife. Lord, give me food. Lord, give me job. God said, but you are everything. You are a selfish prayer person. You are what? You are a selfish prayer person. You have never for one day said, oh God, I pray for a soul to sow in your kingdom. Even when we come for evangelism, you are never there. When the church calls for evangelism, you are never there. But you are expecting miracle. And God says, you are a selfish person. If I give you this miracle, as a matter of fact, it will be useless to me. Because I won't find you in church anymore. You won't even tell any other person that this is what the Lord has done for me. Because you are a selfish seeker. And yet, you want miracle. All things work together. Say, all things work together. For those who love the Lord. For those who seek the Lord, not for those who seek for miracle. Come for evangelism, they won't come. You are not there. Have you ever attended anyone evangelism before this year? Ask yourself. But you are looking for miracle. God said you are a selfish seeker. You are what? A selfish seeker. Lord, release multitude. Lord, as I'm going out today, give me soul. Give me soul. And open your mouth to say, excuse me, sir, are you born again? I'm inviting you to my church this Sunday. We're in our month of signs and wonder. The Lord will give you signs and wonder. How many minutes? It's not even up to 1 minute. You are finished with that one. I'm giving the flyer. You have done your own. To come and do that one, you go. To do it in your office, you won't. How do you think God is enjoying you? And you want it to give you a miracle? Did you see why so many people will be in the house of the Lord for 1 year, for 2 years, for 5 years? Nothing is happening in their life. In fact, they have become shame to the ministry. They're making the man of God to be powerless, whereas they are the ones that are senseless. And you are looking for signs and wonders. I'm sorry. And then another type of prayer is thanksgiving prayer. Say thanksgiving prayer. Say thanksgiving prayer. Say it. Philippians chapter 4 verse 6. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with a thanksgiving, let your request, what? Your request be made known unto God. Philippians 1 verse 19. For I know that this atoned to my salvation through your prayer and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ. Thanksgiving prayer. In everything, by prayer and by supplication. In everything, in your situation now, are you giving him thanks? You have 2 legs. Are you thanking God for these 2 legs? But instead of thanking God for these 2 legs, you are grumbling, you are murmuring. That God, every other person, I'm driving car, they are driving jeep. Me, I'm serving you every day and night. I'm not driving anything. God will say, you won't drive anything till you die. As long as you keep murmuring. Because you can't give him thanks. Even this morning now, the Lord woke you up. You can't say, Father, thank you. Today is the last Sunday of the month. I have come to give you thanks. Instead, you are murmuring. After yourself, you won't see a thanksgiver person on a Sunday service like this will be sleeping in his house or in a house. No, they are ungrateful people, but they want miracle. They want miracle. Be careful for nothing. Please, in your situation today, are you jobless? I'd like you to say, Father, thank you for my job. Say it. Say it. Are you penniless? Father, thank you for my money. Say it. No more at God. In everything, giving thanks. It might not be enough now, but the moment you begin to say, Father, thank you, the Lord begin to see your heart. A grateful heart. A grateful heart. Receive more miracle. So many sisters and brothers, they lost the relationship because they are ungrateful. Not even only to God, but to their own fellow men. You are never grateful to me. You are expecting me to do a miracle for you. For where? I will slap you. That's what most people are receiving in God's now, in their friends. God gave you one boyfriend last year. God gave you husband. Instead of you to be grateful to that husband, to be grateful to that woman, every day of your life is complaining about the man, complaining about the woman. God will say you are ungrateful. Because the time you are looking for this man, the time you are looking for this wife, you are every day fasting and praying. Now I have given you the brother. Instead of you to be appreciating the brother or the sister, you keep complaining about him. You keep complaining about her. Until you lose him or you lose her, then you back to 0-1. And then you will cry and cry till Jesus come. God will say you are not a candidate for husband. You are not a candidate for wife. Because you are ungrateful element. Today is last Sunday of the month. How many people do you see in church that remember that God, I am still alive? And they are in their room, sleeping. They are in their room. Some are even in their church. I mean, in their business. Satan will take. Even Satan will go before the Lord and say, "Oh God, oh God, did you see your sons and daughter?" So when I want to kill him or kill her, I'm telling you that this one is ungrateful to you. God will say, you are correct. Treat him or treat her as you desire. That's the only thing that saved Job. Satan went to God. God, you see this your boy. Let me touch him. You will see he will stop being grateful to you. But Job remained grateful to the Lord. Even in his situation, in his condition, Job keep telling to the Lord, Father, I thank you. All my sons might have died. All my family have died. All my business crumble. Everything get lost the same day. But God, I know you are my redeemer. I know you are my redeemer. And he keeps singing, my redeemer live. My redeemer live. That was all the song he was singing. He was not murmuring. Even when the wife said to him, oh boy, you are still trusting this God? Oh God, you are still going to that church? He said, no, I know my God. I will wait for my time. I will wait until my time comes. He didn't forsake God. He didn't leave God. He didn't leave his church. Many of you will leave your church now because you feel God is not answering you. Whereas you are the stumbling block to yourself. Hey, you are looking for a miracle. You are a miracle seeker. You are not God seeker. Malaso paradea leto Caesar. Thanksgiving! And I'm going to end here and I will continue. I want to show you another channel. I've shown you the channels of prayers and different type of prayers. I have shown you, if you position yourself in the school of faith, I've shown you, if you position yourself in the ministry of the word of God, miracle will definitely locate you. And I want to show you another secret by which you can tap into miracle of God very quickly. Please hear this. You might not hear it anywhere again. It's a secret I want to reveal to you. You might not be able to hear it anywhere because it's a thing that most pastors are afraid to preach. And I'm going to show you the school the channel of relationship. Actually, this is my focus for you this morning. One moment. I want everybody to hear this. There is one crucial channel of miracle that you might never hear except by revelation of God. And that is where many of us are stuck, both spiritually, both physically. There are many people hearing me now that miracle may never come across your way, or may never come across their way because of this disease. I want to show it to you now. Relationship channel. Miracle has a channel. And a powerful channel of miracle is called relationship channel. I studied the word and God began to speak to me when the Lord told me, he said, my son, do you know why I will never visit some people in your church? Do you know I will never show up to some people in anywhere? I said, God told me. He said, come, let me show you. And they began to show me. He said, what is your relationship with me? I said, God, I'm standing well with you. God began to show me a lot of things. He said, are you sure? I said, yes, oh Lord, show me. Am I not? Huh? And then he began to show me so many things. After the end of our conversation, I said, oh God, please help me. Help me. I stretched from my hand and said, oh God, please help me. I thought. He said, you thought, but what about people that are not even thought? He said, tell the word. Relationship. Be a relationship seeker and not a miracle seeker. And when you be a relationship seeker, a relationship builder, he said, I will make you a miraculous. Many physical, spiritual miracle that this brother will have given. The truth of the matter, what you are looking for is in the heart of this brother. Look at the person next sister to you. There is something you are looking for. That person carries it. But do you have a relationship with him? Do you have a relationship with him? If I ask, look at this sister. Look at the two of them. This one we are at Gia. Are you getting me? Look at them very well. Two of you stand up. This one wears what? Ed tie. Uh-huh. This one did not wear. If I ask, hey, now, ma'am, do you like this? She will tell me yes. Okay, ma'am, do you like this type of dress? You like it? Okay. Ma'am, do you have this type of headgear?
Yes.
This type, you have headgear? You have. Good. But this particular type, do you have it?
No.
Now, this is where the thing is. Do you like it? You like to wear this type? The question is this. Truly or genuinely or counterfeit, she might probably not have this type and she likes it. She might probably not even have any idea related to something like this. But this sister had many of these that are even so many in her wardrobe. She like it, she desire it. Are you getting me? But the only channels by which this sister can have this thing by next Sunday is a relationship with this sister. Sit down. Come and give Lord a clap of me. I have a tie now. Somebody like my tie. The truth of the matter is I have so many of these tie. I have so many of these shoes. But the only channel for you to grab my tie or my shoe is the relationship with me. Without my relationship with you or your relationship with me, you are a robber. Because you can only come to my house and steal it. You are a miracle seeker. And
every, and once you are a miracle seeker like that, you will soon become what? You will soon become a robber. You are a thief. And the best a thief can steal is what is available. Are you getting what I'm saying? Without relationship with God, with people, your miracles are limited. In fact, if they are not, never available. Relationship. Let me quickly show you three type of relationship, and then we will stand up to pray. And how these affect or quickened miracles. I will show you a mystery now. There is a professional relationship. Say professional relationship. Say it louder. You must be professional at it. Not only when we are saying that lawyer to lawyer, doctor to doctor. I'm not talking about that. What you are doing, every relationship you are establishing, you are establishing it professionally to the core. Pastors, they associate with pastors. Brother and sister, they associate. You must do it professionally. Not like a novice. Don't do relationship kwa soka. Relationship that have K-leg. You can't get anything from it. Let's look at Bible and buttress it up. I want to show you the parable of the centurion's man. The centurion man's relationship with God. Matthew chapter 8, verse 5, down the line. And when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, there came unto him a centurion, beseeching him, and saying, Lord, my servant lay at home sick of the palsy, grievously tormented. Verse 7. And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. Verse 13. And Jesus said unto centurions, go thy way, as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. And his servant was healed in the same way. The centurion's man met Jesus. Hear what is happening right now. He met Jesus. When Jesus entered into Capernaum, the centurion's man went to him. Are you getting what I'm saying? He said, oh, servant of the Lord, please. Did you see the word? He started begging Jesus, please help me. Please help me. And did you hear what Jesus said to him? And Jesus said, who are you? In fact, he said, please, Jesus, before you even ask me, I am the centurion's man. I am a man of authority, and I know what it means. He said, I'm not asking you to come to my house. Are you getting what I'm saying? He said, I'm not asking you to come to my house, but speak a word. See, he knew by himself he has no relationship with Jesus. He was a miracle seeker. You know what I'm saying? He knew he had no professional. He's a professional person. He's a businessman. It's like somebody you can refer to as doctor. It's like you sitting here now hearing me. People hearing me on the internet is like you, the centurion's man. But he had no what? Relationship with Jesus. He knew Jesus as a miracle worker, but he had no relationship with him. Remember last week I talked about people working with God, people working but not working for him. This one has no relationship with God. Are you getting what I'm saying? There are so many of us here sitting right now, you have no relationship with God. Everything in your heart is against God. When I seek your heart, when I seek your mind, it's dirty. No relationship with God. But look at him, back to where we started. He had faith. That's why miracle is available everywhere to all, anybody. Can I tell you again? Miracle is available to adulterers, fornicator, murderer. Miracle is available to them. Remember that woman, the adulterous woman, when she encountered Jesus, Which what? She encountered Jesus as story change. Remember that man at the right hand of Jesus, a terrible sinner. When he encountered Jesus, miracle came for him. Miracle is available for the adulterous, for the fornicator, for the thief, for everybody. Don't let Satan tell you that you are not an agent of you are not qualified for miracle because you are an adulterer. That is stealing your birthright. Don't let Satan deceive you. Take it that you are not qualified for the miracle. But do you have a relationship with God of miracle? The Capernaum man. He said, please, I'm not worthy for you to come to my house. He has already justified himself. His faith saved him. Why? Remember, I told you last Sunday, one of the channels of miracle is also people compassionate. I will have compassion for those who I want to have compassion with. God will help you. If God did not find compassionate in you, you are dead with your situation. Because when you don't know how to pray, you don't know how to do warfare prayer, you are not evangelizing for God, you are not in anything for God, you are not a thankful giver, you are a murmurer. Tell me, what will God gain from having compassion in you? Because you are satanic, or that person is a satanic friends, not you that are hearing me. But I don't want to get there. That's what I'm teaching you. Anytime Satan is calling you, tell him, no, Satan, no. I'm having a relationship with God. I can have a relationship with you. Do you get what I'm saying? Relationship. Another type of relationship, I'll show you quickly. Personal spiritual relationship. Look at this one. This one will surprise you. Matthew chapter 8, verse 14. And Jesus was called. The same scripture. The same scripture. There are two personalities. We have reading these verses. But you never had this understanding I'm teaching you. The same time. The same city. Are you getting what I'm saying? The same time. The same city, Jesus enter into where? Into Capernaum. The rich man has no relationship with him. He ran unto Jesus because he's a miracle seeker. The same hour, the same time, the same day, Jesus himself enter majestically to somebody's house. And when he enter, miracle that was not requested for happened. Relationship. The same hour, the same church, the same city. I show you quickly now. Let's see. Maybe I'm lying. Let's see. The same. And when Jesus was coming to Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother lay and sick of a fever. Verse 15. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and ministered unto them. Same time, same day, same moment, relationship. Did you see what I'm saying? Peter had what? Good relationship with Jesus. Peter was a follower of Jesus to the core. Not with one mind in, one mind out. He was an addicted follower of Jesus. He had faith in him. He believed in him. So Peter never asked Jesus, please come. My mother is sick. Jesus entered there himself. Do you know what I'm saying? Say relationship. There are some of you, I will never visit your house till Jesus come, because you don't have a relationship with me. That's not the truth. I'm telling you. That's not the truth. We are still 100. Now we are not yet 1,000. We are not yet 5,000. But there are some of you, I might never visit your house, even if you invite me, because you don't have a relationship with me. Don't think you invite me with lunch and dinner, and then I'm carrying myself and my wife, and let's go and eat dinner. Eat dinner. I don't have a relationship with you. You don't have a relationship with me. And you yourself, you know. It's also like you and your boss at office.
Do you have a relationship with your boss? Do you have a relationship with your people you are working with? You are a lone ranger. You are Mr. Perfect and Mrs. Perfect. And you expect those people to give you their hand, help hand. The miracle you are looking for from that office is in the hands of that man or that woman. Go and build your relationship with him or her. And stop stupid crying. Amen. You can die in that office as a penny, as nobody. Because you are nobody to anybody. And they will never respect you as somebody. You are never respecting anybody for somebody. You think they will mind you? In the day of your cry, in the day of divide, they will put more fire to every small mistake you made so that they can sack you. You say you want miracle job. You want promotion. Which promotion? You can't get it because you are not a candidate for it. You don't have public relationship with your people. Stop shouting and crying for nothing. Go and build a relationship. Peter never asked Jesus, please come to my house. Jesus entered. And when he entered, he ministered. Because why? They had a relationship. That woman must have been ministering to Jesus so many times. He said, no, this one cannot seek now. Now we are here. Come and get up and start. And then immediately, what happened? She got a miracle. She didn't sit down and be saying, hey, thank you, Jesus. She started to minister to them. So many of you get the miracle. The miracle you got, even in the house of the Lord, is useless to the Lord. So, if anything happened to it, it's not God, it's you. You have poor relationship with God. You have poor relationship with your neighbor. Your house is burning. Your house is burning. And then people are seeing it. They are not happy to help you to quench it because they know that you are a useless person. You don't have a relationship with your neighbor. Instead, you always throw those bins to their backyard. So when you need their help, they will also throw those bins back to your house. Because you are a woman of no relationship. And you say you want that person to help you. With help. No, ask yourself now. With help. Look at your neighbor now. Look at your neighbor. You want that neighbor to give you the shirt or the shoe he's wearing? Do you have a relationship with him? How would he give you the shoe? Because he doesn't even know your size. Because you don't have a relationship with him or with her. You want that brother to love you? You want that sister to love you? He will, she will, because you are a monster to him or to her. You are what? You are a monster to him or to her. You have never helped her one day. You have never helped him one day. Even when you saw her trekking, you've never said, sister, please come, let me carry you. Because you have looked down on her. That she's a cleaner. After all, she's a cleaner. She's a housekeeper. And when now you are executive. In your executive car, what you needed in that for your life is in the hands of that housekeeper you are talking about. Am I speaking to somebody here this morning? Am I speaking to you this morning? You don't even know the name of the person that's seated by you. What is the name of the person that's seated by you now? I'm asking you. What's the name? The one behind you? The one after you. Some of you are wasting your money every Sunday, every weekend to go and do nail, pedicure, whereas the sister in front of you or beside you can even do it for you for free. My sister and my brother. Peradventure, if you have met yourself in evangelism yesterday, you will be talking about what you are doing. But you will never have a relationship with him or with her. And when I'm talking about relationship, I'm not talking about what's up me, I what's up you, I send you naked picture, you send me naked picture. I'm not talking about that kind of relationship. If you do that kind of relationship, your phone will catch fire. Lastly, I will continue there, but because of my time, lastly, I show you another miracle of the relationship. And then we close there. Relationship. John chapter 11, verse 1. This is where I will stop on this. I will continue next Sunday. Now a certain man was sick. This one will bless you. Let's sit together. One, two, go. Look at the screen. Lame Lazarus of Bethany. the town of Mary and her sister Martha. Verse 2. Whose brother Lazarus was sick. Verse 3. Saying, Lord, behold, whom thou lovest is sick. Read it again. Verse 5. Stay there. Relationship. Say relationship. Tap your partner. Tap your partner. Say relationship. Say tap. Say relationship. Now. Say now. Say now. Where is your relationship now? Jesus loved Martha, her sister, Lazarus, because two of them knew that Jesus is their family friend. They are what? Family friend. They could call him. Please go and bring Jesus and tell Jesus, Jesus, thou brother that thou lovest is dead. We have, when other are trooping him, the centurion's man was looking for him. Please, this one say, I don't need to beg Jesus. My friend, go and tell him that his friend, that he loveth. So Lazarus has good relationship. Say good relationship. Say good relationship. I have never seen somebody with good relationship with God and lack miracles and wonders. I have never seen somebody that have relationship with even the man of God, virtue of God, and lack signs and wonders. Your signs and wonders are quasoko, because sometimes you even say you love the man of God, but your heart is dirty. He said, go and call Jesus. That person that loved it. And he said, and Jesus loved Martha, her sister, Lazarus. That is, they have what? Relationship. They eat together. They dine together. So don't blame me also. When I go to some people's house and I don't come to your house, it's the scriptural. Are you my friend? I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. He calls me so. Are you his friend? Do you have a relationship with him? You just come to church every Sunday. You just come to me and say, Father, 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 but you are Father, 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 Father from me. You are Father, Father. But every Sunday, Father, 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 Father. But every Monday to Saturday, you are Father to me or to these people. But you want them to lay hands on you on Sunday. Pastor Dayo, lay hands. The one is telling you that you are going far. Because you don't have a relationship with him. When does you see his child or his child and carry him and carry her? You say you have a relationship. Your relationship is question mark. And hear what Jesus said in response. Verse 11. This thing said he, Jesus. And after that, he said unto them, Our friend Lazarus sleepeth. But I go that I may wake him out of sleep. Your suffering is temporary. Say, my suffering is temporary. Say, my suffering is temporary. Say, my suffering is temporary. If only I have a relationship with God. If only I have true relationship with God. Rise upon your feet, everybody. Come and give the Lord a clap of for that word. Give the Lord a clap of it. Give the Lord a clap of it. With him, there is a place of prayer, there is a place of fasting, but there is a different place of relationship. Can you get anything from your husband and your wife when two of you are fighting? Hello, married people. Am I talking sense? Boyfriend and girlfriend. Did you go out for the Valentine when two of you are fighting? Because the relationship was shower. Did you get anything from your partner when the relationship is not going well? So, why are you patronizing him or patronizing her? Why are you patronizing God every Sunday? Thinking that you can harass him with coming to church on Sunday. You come to church, you come to church for yourself. Did you come to church for God? Stop harassing God. You are a mouth seeker. You are not a heart seeker. You are what? You are just a talkative. You are not a relationship with God. Come on, somebody pray a prayer this morning. Say, oh Lord, help me to have a relationship with you. Oh Lord, help me to have a relationship with you. Hear this in conclusion. Only a relationship that is established can appreciate each other. Only what? A relationship that are established appreciate each other. Have you ever seen me? Somebody, I'm going on the road and people will say, Pastor Tao, I appreciate you. He doesn't know me. Hello? What? He doesn't know me. So he can't say, Pastor Tao, I appreciate you. Even if I'm driving Jeep or whatever, there are some casual, you look nice. You look nice. You look nice. Those ones are just a mouth. But when I truly look at my daughter now and say, hey, daughter, you look nice. That is from my heart because I know her. I know her name. How many times do you know God and appreciate him? How many times did you appreciate God? That God, you are the one that brought me to see this Sunday, the last Sunday of the month. Only when you know him, that's why you can appreciate him. When you recognize him, you can appreciate him. When you acknowledge him, you can appreciate him. I want you to start with something today. Establish a relationship with God by saying, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Just tell the Lord, Lord, thank you for your relationship with me. If God did not have a relationship with me, he wouldn't send Jesus Christ. He sent me Jesus Christ because of relationship. And I want somebody here to this morning. I don't have time. I wanted to preach to you. I want to show you gratitude. Gratitude as a channel. As a channel of miracle. Gratitude. I want somebody that will say, Lord, I'm grateful to you. I'm grateful. Oh Lord. Let's sing it.
I am grateful. Oh Lord. For all you have done for me. I am grateful.
Appreciate me. Hello?
why would I just see you now and say, hey, my daughter, my son, thank you for last week. Thank you for yesterday. What have you done for me? No, ask yourself. Would you look stupid? Hey, my daughter, thank you for yesterday. Would you ask yourself, what did I do for this man? Hello, is it in the dream or what? There are people here. So also God. I say, okay. How can I just come to you now and say, Eda, take my appreciation letter. For what? Would you say for what? Hello? For what? For what? For what? But if you are giving me something and you brought something to me, I will say, Daddy, thank you for, you brought a card. I say, thank you for the prayer you prayed for me yesterday. Thank you for the ride. I will take it. And I will look for another time that you are stranded. In fact, before you go, I will say, please, anytime you are stranded, call me. Because I know each time I can carry you, I will get a appreciation card. That's how God works. I want you to take something from your pocket. You don't go to God and say thank you from your mouth. Appreciation, there are different types of appreciation. Appreciation by the word and by the hand. Appreciation by the mouth and by the hand. There are many types of appreciation. Appreciation by the mouth and by the cheapest one is by the mouth. The hardest one is by the hand. Hello, all of you, say thank you, Jesus. Say it louder. Say it louder. Say it louder. The loudest one, you see, miracle. They also, you see, it is cheap to say thank you, Jesus. It's a three words label. Thank you, Jesus. It's very cheap, but it's very hard with the hand. Let me see your hand. Do you know the difference between the mouth and the hand? Are they not part of the body? Excuse me, are they not part of the body? One is cheaper, one is harder. And God is looking for the harder one, the hard one. God said, okay, thank you, I have received your mouth. What of your hand? And so many of us say, hey, miracle worker, come and do miracle. God said, okay, what miracle do you want me to do? I want you to do a financial miracle. And what have you brought as a seed of miracle? And I've just give you my mouth. And God said, I also give you my mouth. You are blessed. You are blessed. Hello. Gratitude heart. We always go to God. I say, oh God, I didn't come here with only my mouth. I came with my hand. How many of you go to work with only your hand and your mouth? You didn't go with your leg. Tell me now, you didn't go with your leg. So also, you have come to the church with your leg. Are you hearing me? You have thanked him with your mouth. The next thing is, Father, thank you for the end of the month. And God will say, this one have relationship with me. Take something in your pocket. Every month is your own birthday. Take something to thank God. This last Sunday of the month is your month of joy. It's your month of miracle. Take something from your pocket for the last Sunday of the month to say, Father, thank you.